Someone told me that if you stand up front and you talk to everybody, you get to take your mask off. Are you guys okay with that? Okay. It makes me feel a lot more comfortable. Well, welcome to the St. Matthew's Parish, a special Christmas celebration. This is something a little different tonight, something that you're not accustomed to, and we're very excited to unwrap this for you. We're going to be taking you on a journey, and we have someone that's going to talk about that a little bit later. For now, what I'd like to do is ask Father Tran if he could come forward, welcome you, open us with a prayer, and then we'll start with the program. Father Tran.
Thank you, Tim. Good evening. I'd like to welcome everyone to this annual Christmas concert that St. Matthew's has been doing for the last many years to celebrate the joy of the season. Only a few more days that we are going to celebrate the birth of our Savior once again. So we should have the joyful expectation as we celebrate. And when we are expecting something joyful to come, you know, the spirit is gratitude, thanksgiving, praising God. So tonight, together with the talented members of the choirs and the choral group especially, made up of many members of different choirs coming together, and they have been practicing tirelessly for the last few weeks or months under the committal direction of Peter Luango. So you are going to enjoy a very beautiful night. And we pray that this night will bring you the spirit of joy and gratitude and praising the Almighty God for the gift of His Son and for what we have in our own life. With that in mind, let us ask for God's blessing. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Loving God, we come before you. We acknowledge that you are present among us. You are blessing each and every one of us with many blessings, with the gift of life, the gift of faith, and the gift of new life in Jesus Christ. As we are preparing ourselves once again to celebrate the birth of our Savior, we give you thanks. We have been grateful for your only Son, Jesus Christ. Let this celebration of His birth bring us together and closer to you. We ask you to bless all the members of the choirs who are performing tonight so that the Holy Spirit will be with them, so that they can use their God-talented voice and musical talents to praise you, to entertain us, and to help us to grow in the faith together as a family of St. Matthew's. We ask this through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Enjoy.
Good evening, everyone. So just as Tim has alluded to, I'm going to just make a couple of comments that sort of give you a sense of what it is that makes tonight different. In the Catholic Church, we usually spend about 6 or 7 weeks hearing the Christmas message. Every Sunday, we get a portion of it, starting at Advent all the way through to Epiphany. Tonight, what we're going to do is we're going to take that entire package of readings. All of that scripture is going to be read tonight, and all of it will be accompanied by carols, by songs. We aren't here to perform for you. We're here to lead you in song. We're not here to perform readings to you. We're here to share scripture, the word of God, with you. This is intended as an opportunity for us to get our hearts and our minds ready for Christmas. Yes, we anticipate that it's going to sound really beautiful with your voices too. But really the most important part of this is that it is a celebration not just of groups that are performing for you, but rather of us celebrating the arrival of our Savior. So, as you hear, especially in the first portion of the program, the first lengthy portion, we're not looking for you to clap after each piece. In fact, We're hoping that you will sing with us. You're going to hear the choir, the chorus, sing in four-part harmony, and you're welcome to join them. Now, if you want to just listen to the words, that's okay. But in your programs that you've been given are the numbers in your Glory and Praise book, so you actually can take part with us. All right? Choir, I'm going to ask you, chorus, to come up now at this time. The other thing that's going to happen through this reading is that we are also going to have some folks that are going to do some storytelling. And you'll hear a few little stories told that help, again, to get our hearts ready for the Christmas season. So with that said, get ready to be inspired and get ready to be moved as we prepare for Christmas.
Good evening, everyone. This first poem will give you a different perspective on the candy cane. It's called Candy Cane Christmas by Helen Heidel. Do you know the story of candy canes and God's great love? Why we celebrate his birth and why Jesus came to earth? Candy canes can tell us all of God's Son, born weak and small. Jesus, God's great gift of love, sent to earth from heaven above. Candy canes were first made white because the baby born that night was the pure and holy one, Jesus Christ, God's only son. Candy canes look like a J for Jesus born this day. Jesus is his special name, Savior from all sin and shame. Now a shepherd's staff you see, my good shepherd cares for me. I am weak, but he is strong. He is with me all day long. Stripes on candy canes are red, like the blood that Jesus shed. See the scars and wounds he bore. See the crown of thorns he wore. Now you know the story of candy canes and God's great love, why we celebrate his birth and why Jesus came to earth. Celebrate this Christmas day. Love each other, hug and pray. Share some candy, laugh and sing. Jesus loves us, he's our King.
Come, let us worship the King. Jesus the Savior is born, for the Lord will
and the Lord of Lords, he is wonderful. Great. Hallelujah, whose salvation and holiness and the Lord. The birth of John the Baptist foretold. In the days of Herod, king of Judea, there was a priest named Zechariah of the division of Abijah. And he had a wife of the daughters of Aaron, and her name was Elizabeth. And they were both righteous before God, walking in all the commandments and ordinances of the Lord, blameless. But they had no child, because Elizabeth was barren, and both were advanced in years. Now, while he was serving as priest before God, when his division was on duty, according to the custom of the priesthood, it fell to him by lot to enter the temple of the Lord and burn incense. And the whole multitude of the people were praying outside at the hour of incense. And there appeared to him an angel of the Lord standing on the right side of the altar of incense. And Zechariah was troubled when he saw him, and fear fell upon him. But the angel said to him, "Do not be afraid, Zechariah, for your prayer is heard, and your wife Elizabeth will bear you a son, and you shall call his name John. And you will have joy and gladness, and many will rejoice at his birth, for he will be great before the Lord, and he shall drink no wine nor strong drink. And he will be filled with the Holy Spirit even from his mother's womb. And he will turn many of the sons of Israel to the Lord their God. And he will go before him in the spirit and power of Elijah, to turn the hearts of the fathers to the children, and the disobedient to the wisdom of the just, to make ready for the Lord a people prepared." And Zechariah said to the angel, "How shall I know this? For I am an old man, and my wife is advanced in years." And the angel answered him, "I am Gabriel, who stand in the presence of God, and I was sent to speak to you and to bring you this good news." After these days, his wife Elizabeth conceived, and for 5 months she hid herself, saying, "Thus the Lord has done to me in the days when he looked on me, to take away my reproach among men."
In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent from God to a city of Galilee named Nazareth, to a virgin betrothed to a man whose name was Joseph, of the house of David, and the virgin's name was Mary. And he came to her and said, "Hail, O favored one, the Lord is with you." But she was greatly troubled at the saying, and considered in her mind what sort of greeting this might be. And the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall call his name Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give to him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over the house of Jacob forever. And of his kingdom there will be wind. Mary said to the angel, "How shall this be, since I have no husband?" And the angel said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be called Holy, the Son of God. And behold, your kinswoman, Elizabeth, in her old age, has also conceived a son. And this is the sixth month with her who was called barren. For with God, nothing will be impossible." And Mary said, "Behold, I am the handmaid of the Lord. Let it be to me according to your word." And the angel departed from her.
In those days, Mary arose and went with haste into the hill country, to a city of Judah, and she entered the house of Zechariah and greeted Elizabeth. And when Elizabeth heard the greeting of Mary, the babe leaped in her womb, and Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Spirit, and she exclaimed with a loud cry, "Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. And why is this granted me, that the mother of my Lord should come to me? For behold, when the voice of your greeting came to my ears, the babe in my womb leaped for joy. And blessed is she who believed that there would be a fulfillment of what was spoken to her from the Lord." And Mary remained with her about 3 months and returned to her home. Now the time came for Elizabeth to be delivered, and she gave birth to a son. And her neighbors and kinsfolk heard that the Lord had shown great mercy to her, and they rejoiced with her. And on the eighth day they came to circumcise the child, and they would have named him Zechariah after his father. But his mother said, "Not so. He shall be called John." And they said to her, "None of your kindred is called by this name." And they made signs to his father, inquiring what he would have called him. And he asked for a writing tablet and wrote, "His name is John." And they all marveled. And immediately his mouth was opened and his tongue loosed, and he spoke, blessing God. And fear came on all their neighbors. And all these things were talked about through all the hill country of Judea. And all who heard them laid them up in their hearts, saying, "What then will this child be? For the hand of the Lord was with him." And his father Zechariah was filled with the Holy Spirit and prophesied, saying, "Blessed be the Lord God of Israel, for he has visited and redeemed his people, and has raised up a horn of salvation for us in the house of his servant David, as he spoke by the mouth of his holy prophets from of old, that we should be saved from our enemies and from the hand of all who hate us, to perform the mercy promised to our fathers, and to remember his holy covenant, the oath which he swore to our father Abraham, to grant us that we, being delivered from the hand of our enemies, might serve him without fear, in holiness and righteousness before him all the days of our life. And you, child, will be called the prophet of the Most High, for you will go before the Lord to prepare his ways, to give knowledge of salvation to his peoples in the forgiveness of their sins, through the tender mercy of our God, when the day shall dawn upon us from on high, to give light to those who sit in darkness and in the shadow of death, to guide our feet into the way of peace." And the child grew and became strong in spirit, and he was in the wilderness till the day of his manifestation to Israel.
From Matthew chapter 1, the birth of Jesus the Messiah. Now the birth of Jesus Christ took place in this way. When his mother Mary had been betrothed to Joseph, before they came together, she was found to be with child of the Holy Spirit. And her husband Joseph, being a just man and unwilling to put her to shame, resolved to divorce her quietly. But as he considered this, behold, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream, saying, Joseph, son of David, do not fear to take Mary, your wife, for that which is conceived in her is of the Holy Spirit. She will bear a son, and you shall call his name Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins. All this took place to fulfill what the Lord had spoken by the prophet. Behold, a virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and his name shall be called Emmanuel, which means God with us. When Joseph woke from sleep, he did as the angel of the Lord commanded him. He took his wife, but knew her not until she had borne a son. And he called his name Jesus.
In those days, a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that all the world shall be enrolled. This was the first enrollment when Quirinius was governor of Syria, and all went to be enrolled, each to his own city. And Joseph also went up from Galilee, from the city of Nazareth to Judea, to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be enrolled with Mary, his betrothed, who is with child. And while they were there, the time came for her to be delivered. And she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling cloths and laid him in a manger because there was no place for them in the inn.
Thank you.
And in that region, there were shepherds out in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And an angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were filled with fear. And the angel said to them, "Be not afraid, for behold, I bring you good news of a great joy which will come to all the people. For to you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. And this will be a sign for you. You will find a babe wrapped in swaddling cloths and lying in a manger." And suddenly, there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly hosts praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace among men with whom he is pleased." Went away from them into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go over to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has made known to us." And they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the babe lying in a manger. And when they saw it, they made known the saying which had been told them concerning this child. And all who heard it wondered at what the shepherds told them. But Mary kept all these things, pondering them in her heart. And the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen as it had been told them.
Mm-hmm.
And at the end of 8 days, when he was circumcised, he was called Jesus, the name given by the angel before he was conceived in the womb. For the Father's will is that everyone who looks to the Son and believes in him shall have eternal life, and I will raise them up at the last day. This is the reason that Jesus came to the earth, to save his people from their sins by his life, death, and resurrection. He is King of Kings, Lord of Lords, our Savior.
Thank you.
I just do want to very much indicate that these folks, for the last 7 Wednesdays in a row, put up with me in the rehearsal room for about 1.5 hours or 2 hours. They come from virtually all the choirs in the parish. They represent this parish. Some of these folks don't sing in a choir, but should be, because they're in the parish and they should join. I just want to say again that they had made a commitment to make sure that they would help make your Christmas special, and I hope that we've managed to do that tonight. Thank you very much. Thank you to you guys.
It was probably, I guess, 2 months ago, 2.5 months ago, when Peter came to me and said, Tim, you know, I think we need to do something different for our Christmas concert this year. And, you know, we've all been apart through this crazy COVID pandemic. We haven't been able to come together and enjoy each other and support each other. And he said, wouldn't it be wonderful if we could have a combined choir and have as many voices as we can from all the choirs and really have a heartfelt Christmas celebration, as opposed to one choir after another with carols, which is wonderful and we enjoy that so much. But we wanted to bring a little bit more of the spirituality, the story of the birth of Jesus. We wanted to bring that into this event this evening. And I think with the choir backing it up, it was an absolutely wonderful experience. Wouldn't you say so? Wasn't that a wonderful experience? Yeah? Absolutely. You know, this is the second year that we've had to do a little bit of a pivot. And as much as, you know, we have all of you here with us tonight, which we're so thankful for. Thank you for being here with us. We also have many people at home watching us on a live stream, because this whole event has been live streamed and is being live streamed as well. So to all you out there that are watching from home, God bless you. And I hope this has made your Christmas a little bit more of what the meaning of the season truly is. You know, in today's busy world, we tend to lose a little bit of that, even ourselves. And so it's wonderful. Peter, again, I thank you for that wonderful, wonderful presentation this evening. Now, it's not over yet. We also now have 4 wonderful choirs that are going to present to us. But before we do that, I just want to remind you, as last year and every year, this concert, we try and use it as a bit of a fundraiser for St. Vincent de Paul. For all those people a little bit less fortunate maybe than ourselves, it's a wonderful opportunity to, you know, support them and give them a Christmas that they maybe wouldn't have otherwise. So please, I've been asked to read you a little bit of a story. And as I'm reading that story, please think about a gift that you would make to St. Vincent de Paul, and we will have the ushers going around with baskets to collect that donation. Thank you. The name of this story is called The Christmas Guest by Helen Steiner Rice. It happened one day at the year's white end, two neighbors called on an old-time friend. And they found his shop, so meager and mean, made merry with 1,000 boughs of green. And Conrad was sitting there with a face of shine when he suddenly stopped as he stitched a twine. And said, old friends, at dawn today, when the cock was crowing the night away, the Lord appeared in a dream to me and said, I'm coming to be a guest with me. So I've been busy with feet astir, strewing my shop with branches of fir. The table is spread, the kettle is shined, and over the rafters the holly is twined. And now I will wait for my Lord to appear and listen closely, so I will hear. He stepped as he nears my humble place, and I open the door and look in his face. So his friends went home and left Conrad alone, for this was the happiest day he had known. For long since, his family had passed away, and Conrad has spent a sad Christmas day. But he knew with the Lord as his Christmas guest, this Christmas would be the dearest and best. And he listened with only joy in his heart, and with every sound, he would rise with a start. He would look for the Lord to be standing there in answer to his earnest prayer. So he ran to the window after hearing a sound, but all that he saw on the snow-covered ground was a shabby beggar whose shoes were torn, and all his clothes were ragged and worn. So Conrad was touched and went to the door and said, "Your feet must be frozen and sore. And I have some shoes in my shop for you and a coat that will keep you warmer too." So with a grateful heart, the man went away. But as Conrad noticed the time of day, he wondered what made the dear Lord so late and how much longer he would have to wait. When he heard a knock at the door, he ran, but it was only a stranger once more, a bent old crone with a shawl of black, a bundle of kindling on her back. She asked for only a place to rest, but that was reserved for Conrad's great guest. But her voice seemed to plead, "Don't send me away. Let me rest a while on Christmas Day." So Conrad brewed her a steaming cup, and she sat at the table and sipped it up. But after she left, he was filled with dismay, for he saw that the hours were passing away, and the Lord had not come as he said he would, and Conrad felt sure he had misunderstood. When out of the stillness he heard a cry, "Please help me and tell me, where am I?" So again he opened his friendly door and stood disappointed as twice before. It was only a child who had wandered away and was lost from her family on Christmas Day. Again Conrad's heart was heavy and sad, but he knew he should make this little girl. So he called her in and wiped her tears and quieted her childish fears. Then he led her back to her home once more. But as he entered his own darkened door, he knew that the Lord was not coming today, for the hours of Christmas had passed away. So he went to his room and knelt down to pray, and he said, "Dear Lord, why did you delay? What kept you from coming to call on me? For I wanted so much your face to see." When in the soft silence, a voice he heard, "Lift up your head, for I kept my word. Three times my shadow crossed your floor. Three times I came to your lonely door. For I was the beggar with bruised and cold feet. I was the woman you gave to eat. And I was the child on the homeless street. Three times I knocked, and three times I came in. And each time I found the warmth of a friend. Of all the gifts, love is the best, and I was honored to be your Christmas guest. Thank you for listening.
Thank you, Tim. I am so pleased to read for you now a short poem called Precious Presence by Heather Price. Listen carefully to the words of this poem. It speaks about the most precious gifts of God, the ones that he bestows on all people. See if you can guess who they are. Precious Presence. Some come to us wrapped in packages of glitter and gold. Some are wrapped in paper of brown, a beauty yet to unfold. These presents will never be found under a Christmas tree, for these precious presents are found in each child that we see. Precious presents God sends for the earth to borrow, laughter, hugs, and toothless grins, the future of tomorrow. We find them in our classrooms with hearts full of love, tiny blessings that remind us of our calling from above. They are miracles of God, touched by his love and grace, believing in magic and hoping we keep the world a safe place. They wait for us to unwrap them so they can spread their wings and fly. Once tiny caterpillars that emerge as fragile, beautiful butterflies. These precious presents are never tied with ribbons or with bows. They are God's promise after the storm, beautiful rainbows. So unwrap these precious presents and keep them safe from harm. Love them, treasure them, and hold them tight in the comfort of your arms. When you open these precious presents, love them from the start. Hold tight to God's little blessings because they are treasures of the heart. And now I would like to introduce to you our St. Matthew's Elementary School Choir. They will be singing a song they've been working hard under the direction of Mrs. Denise Fawcett, our choir director and music teacher at St. Matthew's, and Mrs. Vivian Sobrero, who's our accompanist. They will sing All on This Holy Silent Night. Please welcome the St. Matthew's Elementary Performance Choir.
Wasn't that amazing? Oh my goodness, you know, when you see these young people that sing so beautifully at this age. Peter, I saw you look, yes, please, let's hear you another round of applause. You know, I looked around the room and I noticed some of our choir directors paying particular attention to these young children, going, oh, I want that one, and that one I think will be very good in our choir. It was just wonderful, great. The next choir that we have is our Vietnamese choir, and we're so excited to have them. And I just want to say, I was at an event at Gardens of Gethsemane a couple of weeks back, and our choir came and sang when the Archbishop from Kamloops was there, and it's the first time I'd ever heard the Vietnamese choir, and I was extremely, extremely impressed. This evening, they're going to sing a song that's entitled God's Homeland. And they've asked me to read just a brief introduction to this song. Jesus Christ is the light that shines in the darkness of humanity. And this is the sign to recognize him, a newborn babe, wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. The stars shine bright in the sky, and the angels all sing, glory in excelsis Deo. It is by this sign that the shepherds had found the Messiah. Tonight, joining all the churches around the world, we celebrate the birth of our newborn King. A holy joy as we open our heart and soul, as we wish to enter into the homeland of God, to feel the true peace. That was wonderful. Thank you so much for that beautiful, beautiful song. Thank you. See, I told you, they're really, really good. Okay. The next choir we have coming up is a group of young adults. In fact, the name of their group is called the Young Adults of Surrey. It's a young adults ministry that was started by Father Lucio a number of years back, and they took a couple of steps backwards over COVID, but now Father Salvino has kind of taken them under his wing, and that group is now coming back, and we're so happy to have them here with us this evening to sing their song, which I have the title right here on my program. You know what it is, don't you? In the bleak midwinter. Thank you.
In the bleak midwinter,
Boy, being under a microscope singing harmonies a cappella, my goodness, that was wonderful. Thank you for that. Beautiful, beautiful. Our last presentation for this evening is our St. Matthew's the Apostle Choir, and it is coming up now. They're coming down. I think they're coming on a stage, and the title of their song this evening is Born on Christmas Day. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, that concludes our program for this evening. But as we send you away, I must say, all the concerts that I've attended, I've never heard such a high quality of presentation from all the choirs. And it was an absolute delight to have the feature presentation. I hope you enjoyed that. But then to hear these choirs to send us on our way, absolutely amazing. Once again, please, let's hear it for this choir. Absolutely. And another big round of applause for the children's choir. Let's hear it for them as well. Absolutely. Wow. Fantastic. And of course, the Vietnamese choir. What a beautiful rendition. And once again, I have to bring back to memory that wonderful a cappella performance by the Young Adults of Surrey. Let's hear it for them again as well. And you know, one of the songs that I enjoyed the most, I think, was Silent Night, because I heard you singing. And even I was singing, and it was wonderful to join in and to sing. And of course, I think when you join in and sing, it's like anything else. When you participate, you get a lot more from it. And I think, and I hope, that it touched your hearts and has prepared you a little bit more for the coming of our Lord on Christmas Day. I hope this has prepared you to have a Christmas better than one you've had for a few years. So again, thank you all for being here. I hope you had an opportunity to donate to the St. Vincent de Paul. I know they count on this event quite a bit in terms of being able to support the families in need out there in our parish community. So if you haven't had a chance to do that, please, on your way out, if you could do that, that would be wonderful. I now would like to call Father Tran back to close the evening, say a few words, and end us in a prayer.
Well, thank you, Tim. Well, obviously, you know, you enjoyed it the night, you are staying here until the last minute. So not only enjoying, but I pray and I hope too that the whole night truly bring back the spirit of Christmas. As I was sitting, you know, back then and watching, and then an hour and a half enjoying the singing, certainly, but the spirit did come and bring back that Christmas spirit that we're supposed to have. We are so busy doing different things, and of course, you know, in the next few days, you know, as a priest too, you know, mass and everything is going, but this is so precious, and I appreciate it so much. And I thank you so much, you know, first of all, Tim McKinnon. You know, Tim is the new chairperson of our parish council, replacing Bill Bowman for so many years. But so the team has been working closely with Peter Luango and with the chorus made up of many members of the choirs in the parish. Thank you so much for doing that and tirelessly practicing for the last 7 weeks. Thank you so much. And of course, the four choirs singing the four performances, the second part there. And truly appreciate for your dedication and your faith. And as a parish of St. Matthew's, as the church, of Catholic Church, we still feel with joy and blessing, even though COVID is still present, but it will be gone soon because we have the faith in God and God's protecting every one of us. So see you at Christmas for sure. And then we'll continue to celebrate the birth of our Savior. Thank you so much for being here. So now we ask for God's blessing. Send our way. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Loving God, once again, we feel your presence in the midst of us. You have truly come into our own hearts through the praising and singing of our people, rejoicing for the gift of salvation in your Son, Jesus Christ. We pray that this spirit of Christmas will truly open our hearts to welcome you and keep you with us forever. We ask you to bless each and every one of us and our families with safety, with good health, and with joy, peace, and happiness throughout this season. And we ask this to Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Merry Christmas.
Thank you, everybody. Good night.